get real adoption, eh? Because it's quite complicated to use and understand and to secure, and how do you really get it used? Bitcoin had a good start, and here they accept payments in Bitcoin and some merchants in Ghent, but things went wrong a little bit with Bitcoin, transaction fees went up a lot, and so it's not really very practical anymore to use for small payments, and that's really a big pity. And there's also some other problems, like Bitcoin does not offer that much privacy. You have to think very well about how you use it if you want privacy. And some other coins like Monero and Zcash have better solutions. But Bybal, for example, also has it exists of two coins. It's Bytes and it's Black Bytes. And the Bytes is just visible, traceable, but the Black Bytes not. So I think that's a very good thing to have. But so Bybal, what is different? Well, it's a totally different technology. It's called DAG. And so it's different DAG from blockchain, in that blockchain, they save all the history, all since inception. So the blockchain of Bitcoin is 9 years old now, and all the transactions are recorded in it and stay in it. And it becomes difficult. It becomes very big, the blockchain. With the DAG, the history is not saved, only the end result is saved. So who has which coins, but not where all the coins were before, as I understand it. I'm not a technician, I will certainly make some mistakes, but that's how I understand it. And so that allows it to stay more decentralized. Another thing interesting is that it doesn't use miners to validate transactions. It's more that when you do a transaction, the next person that does the transaction is basically building on your transaction, and so transactions, they build on each other and that way are validated. And so that's a different approach. And as I understand it, this allows just a cryptocurrency to scale much more easily while also staying decentralized. Also while keeping the transaction fees low, which is very important. So that's cool. You have some other coins also using that new technology, DAG, like IOTA, and there's a few others too, but it's pretty new. And something else I like about Bybal is that the way it has distributed the coins. So with Bitcoin, the new coins come into the market via miners. The miners, they validate transactions, and if they do that correctly, then they get newly issued coins. With Bybal, it's different. The coins are basically given away for free. So 99% of the coins, of the limited supply that's created in the beginning, will be given away for free, but the goal of the distribution is to get adoption. And so the way it has started doing that is by giving to all Bitcoin holders free bytes. But they have to register their Bitcoins, and the more Bitcoins they have registered, the more bytes they got. And that's been going on the past almost year now, every month the distribution. And that makes that a lot of, like, about a million Bitcoins have participated, like more and more every month. And so a lot of Bitcoiners also have bytes today. And so that's interesting, I think. That's very good, because the founder, Tony, he says, like, the value of a currency is dependent on how many people have it and use it. And so even though you may be giving away free bytes, if those people really start using it and saving in it, then that's a profitable transaction for everybody, because all the bytes will become more valuable. That's a very good idea. But now that's a little bit, they are starting to focus on different distribution methods. Like, they have started the cashback program. And so that means that if a merchant starts that, if you go and pay a merchant in crypto, well, then if the merchant is participating in the cashback program, then they will get the user will get 10% of what they bought with that merchant back in bytes. It's for free. And if they pay with Bytes and not just another crypto, they get 20% back. And so that's a way to get new users, because basically it will be also people that just don't use Byteball yet. They will get that cashback, but they have to install a wallet for that. And so they get familiar with Bytes because they get some for free. So that's a program that's just started now, two months back, and about 22 merchants have started adopting using that, but that can grow a lot. I like it very much. And another idea, but that's for later, is to give everybody free Bytes that just installs the wallet. I think it's also very all very important to get people to start using the coin. So the distribution is interesting. And what else? Let me scroll here a little. What I like very much also, it's very easy to use, so I'm going to give free Bytes for everybody that's here that's interested, but you will have to install the wallet, but it's just very simple to install, and also very simple to secure. I like it also very much, because that's such a hassle securing your coins, but the way Byteball works is just like you install that and you don't have to secure it, you don't have to do nothing, you can immediately receive Bytes and black Bytes without creating any code, but you can also, after you have built up some, start securing it, and so you can just add a password, along with password, and then it will be encrypted, and that's already more secure, but that's not super secure. But what you can do, for example, is create a multi-device wallet. So you create a wallet on your phone, but also on your laptop or your desktop, and then you say, like, if you want to do a transaction, it needs to be signed also by the other device. So that means that if your laptop is hacked, for example, well, the hacker can't send your Bytes away, because every transaction also needs to be signed by your phone. Yeah? So and it works very easily. You do a transaction, you say send, and then you choose, okay, who else needs to sign? You say, okay, my phone. And then you immediately get a pop-up on your phone, ah, you want to sign this transaction or not. So this is a very easy way to secure your coins. You can also secure it with other people, like you say you want to give some coins to someone you love, and then you just set up a multi-device wallet so that if they lose their phone, for example, they lose their coins, but not in this case, because you set up a multi-device wallet, you actually also have access to their coins. So you can send them too. So that's very nice. Okay, so we're getting to a close here. What else is important? Well, did I say everything? Well, conditional payments is also very interesting. So you can say, like, okay, I'm gonna pay you so many Bytes, but you will only get them when you pay me, for example, so many black Bytes. And then first, the other person needs to pay the black Bytes, and only when you receive the black Bytes, then automatically your Bytes will go to the other person. It's a conditional payment, but that makes that people have created a whole decentralized exchange around this with much less counterparty risk than you have on a centralized exchange. But with these conditional payments, you can do many other things also, like people are creating all kinds of bots for sports betting or insurance. That's very interesting. And I think I've said a lot of it. So that's it. Any questions, guys? Anybody has a question? No? Yeah?
How many byte balls were on the board?
So there is 10,000. 1 million gigabytes. And that's also interesting. You have bytes, but then you have 1,000 bytes is 1 kilobyte, 1 million bytes is 1 megabyte, 1 billion bytes is 1 gigabyte. So it's really built up the way computer data also is built up. It's very interesting. So I think it's 1 million gigabytes, and 600,000 gigabytes have already been distributed. The remaining 400,000 still has to be distributed. Yeah. And in black bytes is 2.1111 more in circulation than bytes. So there is not 1 million, but 2.111 million gigabytes black or in total will be in circulation.
Can identify?
Yeah, that's very interesting. So you get bytes, but you also get black bytes. And so yeah, if you want to do a private transaction, you can just send black bytes. But for that, you need to pair up the devices. You can't just give your Bible address to someone and then they cannot send black bytes yet. You still have to pair up your devices, which is very easy to do, but it's extra work. But that's because it's a different system. It's not sent on the blockchain or on the DAG. It's sent from device to device, and only the devices themselves know about those black byte transfers. Nobody else knows about it. That's why you have to pair up the devices. For black bytes, not for bytes. For bytes, you can just give your Bible address over the internet, and you can
see. Anybody else? You can buy a Bible on a major exchange, of course. But what about the black bytes? And what is the future for investors?
Yeah. So a very interesting. What's the value of bytes? Because if it's worth billions already, there's not much opportunity there, I think. So the bytes is valued only at 100 million. Which is now a position of 55th largest crypto. So it's ranked in the mid caps because 55 is pretty low, but it's also not number 500. So it's a mid cap coin and it's only worth 100 million. I think that's very low. But the 100 million valuation is on the bytes, the 1 million gigabytes. The black bytes are not valued on coin market cap because they are not traded on a centralized exchange. They only traded in the wallet themselves. You can trade with others or via decentralized exchanges. And so, but the total valuation of all the black bytes is right now 10 million. I think that's ridiculously low and a great opportunity to invest. So your question was?
Black bytes.
Yeah.
Where can we get them?
Well, you have to install a wallet and then you can just buy them. The website is free. And there you can see the order books.
So it's not, and it's not going to come on a major exchange?
No, it's via your wallet that you trade. Okay. It's pretty cool, actually. Any other questions?
Are you the YouTuber?
Yes.
I like your videos.
Thank you. Any other questions? So I'm giving free bytes. If you install the wallet, Android phone only right now, iPhone is not possible, but Mac is possible. Then I'm very happy to send you some bytes and black bytes. But if it's not possible today, if you could just give me your email, I'll start the paper here with the pen, and then I will email you, and then we can do it later. This is my website, YouTube channel, Mark De Mezel. I talk about crypto, Lambos, and girls. Okay, thank you so much.